कुसुजम बोला नमस्ते गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल रेस्पेक्टेड व्यूअर्स लॉन्ग लिव आवर किंग्स लॉन्ग लिव आवर एसोसिएशन एंड लॉन्ग लिव आवर लीडर्स वेलकम टू दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन एम्बेसी ऑफ इंडिया कल्चरल सेंटर सो टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू रिसाइट ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट श्लोक आर इंपॉर्टेंट आयुर्वेद टेक्स्ट रिटन बाय वाग भट्टाचार्य फ्रॉम अष्टांग हृदय ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टेक्स्ट इन आयुर्वेद सो रोगाधि रोगान सततानुशुक्तान शेषकाय प्रवृतान शेषान औत्सुख्य मोहो रतिधांजघाना यह पूर्व वैद्याय नमोस्तस्मै सैल्यूटेशंस टू द यूनिक एंड रेयर फिजिशियन हू हैज डिस्ट्रॉयड विदाउट एनी रेसिड्यू ऑल द डिसीजेस लाइक रागा रागा मीन्स अटैच्ड टू द बॉडी लाइक लस्ट ग्रीड एरोगेंस जेलस सेल्फिशनेस लाइक एंड ईगो एंड विच आर कॉन्स्टेंटली एसोसिएटेड विद द बॉडी एंड गिविंग राइज टू डिसीज एंड डेल्यूजन एंड रेस्टलेसनेस दिस रेस्टलेसनेस ऑल्सो called as vritti vritti means as Patanjali also mentioned that yogah chitta vritti nirodah chitta vritti means activities of the mind if once activities of the mind will be stopped and now our mind and body and soul will getting free from all diseases and disorders so that's what we call in ayurveda text as well as in patanjali text so right let us come to the our ayurveda workshop so here yesterday we saw that important technique called mouth strengthening technique or teeth strengthening technique the day before yesterday we did that kadha chai also very good to give mouth refresh mouth freshener as a mouth freshener so today I would like to introduce a very important technique for mouth ulcers many people have been suffering from this mouth ulcers because of overheat inside or gastric troubles or over stress and over fear or some of the remaining disorders from the like intestines some of the diseases of intestines also may rise may give that mouth ulcer that's a different thing but in regular cases how to get rid of this mouth ulcers first thing is remove the constipation in a day try to drink more hot water to clean the abdomen if before you are eating the food please see that your abdomen must be free from the constipation after that add the new food like our eating and digestion also it's one kind of preparation one kind of cooking inside so how we are cleaning the vessel before we are cooking the same process before we are eating first clean your abdomen then after that add fresh food and here in this record see if you have mouth ulcers especially inside the lips or on the tongue or inside the cheeks so try to cut one tea bag like a dip tea bag after using your tea bag see this must be like a warm or cool now try to put that as it is tea bag on that wound so basically these tea bags are tannins and some other chemical that will be very good for your ulcers second thing is add ice cubes that's also temporary that will relieve the pain from temporary then second important thing is see here I am we have honey and we have haldi so I am requesting my videographer to come here once so here very simple preparation take a small quantity of haldi like yellow turmeric and very small quantity of honey so try to mix it as a paste very simple technique very effective technique basically we know that honey is a very good antibacterial as well as pain reliever also so try to mix with it like a paste all right and now your paste is ready so try to use this turmeric and honey paste to apply around your wounds then after that after a few minutes then again you can wash your mouth then another application is all our homes are having tezpatta it's a masala ingredient and now try to add two amla Indian gooseberry and tezpatta then just try to boil it and try to boil it and make a decoction make a decoction so always try to use this decoction to clean your mouth very simple preparation then next important thing is water and coriander leaves just boil it after boiling this water will turn into green then in that try to add lavang very simple ingredient then again mix it properly or boil it properly then after that take the decoction out then again wash your mouth thoroughly then that is a other preparation. Now next preparation is, this is what we call leaves of bamboo, everywhere available in Bhutan, okay? Bamboo leaves, try to cut the bamboo leaves and make decoction again, add water and make decoction. So in this decoction, you can add you can add lemon and you can add ginger, 1 or 2 drops ginger, and prepare it more, and after giving that color of green or somewhat brownish color, and now try to take that decoction out and wash your mouth properly. And first thing is, cut your overeating and always try to see your mouth mouth bad smell. If once you will feel that bad smell, do not depend on chewing gums. Immediately clean the mouth with the water or with the finger or with the available brushes, so that always carry your toothbrush in your handbag, okay? So right, and now coming to our yoga practices. So meanwhile, I'm requesting our videographer to shoot every ingredients what we are displaying on this display board, Ayurveda display board. Very important, all our home ingredients available in every home. Okay, now coming to the yoga session, after your warm-ups and after your traditional prayers, before commencing your any kind of physical exercises including yoga, try to always use this kneecaps for especially senior citizens or the people who are very active in the leg stretchings, okay? It will somewhat protect your knees. Okay, now after your warm-ups, come to your sun salutations. According to your time, depend on your time, you can choose 3 or 4 or 6, even 12 also, but here as per our time constraint, now we are doing only one. Then inhalation, lift the arms up and come straight. Then after that, very slowly with exhalation, forward bend and right leg stretch back, push your body forward. And I'm requesting my videographer to once shoot the leg back stretching also. So many people actually it is no mistake, but you can keep your toes in the standing or in the flat, okay? But before coming to the next posture, first keep your toes straight and keep your forward leg to back. Then from there, Ashtanga Namaskarasana, and completely rest and lift the chin up as a lifted head cobra posture, lift and stay. And from there, mountain triangular posture, lift and stay. And right leg forward and few seconds stay horse riding posture. Then after that, back leg straight and back leg joint to the forward leg. Then from there, lift your both the arms with inhalation, then and relaxations, enough, come straight. Okay, now slowly release your arms and relax your arms, resting. So coming to our next pattern of the practice in the standing, today my plan is to give some balancing posture related to Natarajasana, okay? Then very simple exercises to for your abdomen fat reduction, as well as for flexibility, as well as for your hip girdle stretching also. Very simple exercise. Keep your position straight, choose any good surface, keep your position straight, or you can even choose your wall as a supporter. So lift your right leg up to the left side, turn your right leg and open your right arm to the right side, and few seconds stay here. So throughout the practice, keep turn your body back, your right arm still open back, and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 relaxations, enough, come back. Then slowly stride, one long inhalation, exhalation. Then opposite side, same exercise, change your leg style and hold. Then after that, turn your knee towards opposite side, use your above folded leg side's hand, turn to the back and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then very slowly get back, relaxation. Then during the same exercise, so we have the same exercise pattern with open leg. First keep your body straight, then after that lift your right leg up, turn your right leg to the left side, catch your right leg ankle with the left hand, keep your body straight and open your above folded leg side hand to the concerned side. Now to the opposite side, open your leg and stay for a while. So according to your convenience, keep open your leg and hand properly. So throughout the practice, keep observe your abdomen press and hip girdle turn, and few seconds stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and relaxations, enough, come back. Again, slowly keep your leg down and hand down, one long inhalation and exhalation. Then same exercise, opposite side, change your leg style, hold. Then after that, choose any wall support if you want. Now completely rotate your body back and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 relaxations, enough, come back. Okay, take again long, slow inhalation and exhalation. So next exercise related to standing forward bend. If you have any lower back issues or neck issues, avoid practice or you can use bricks or any stool or any height to put the arms. But this is first exercise like Murdhasana or like Vistarita Pada Hastasana. Now few seconds, keep your legs wide and observe your breath, observe your resting. Then after that, lift your both the arms up with inhalation. And with exhalation, very slowly bend the body forward. So throughout the practice, don't crunch your back or don't hunch your spine. Now completely bent, keep your hands on the floor. And from here, drag your hands down and stretch your hands towards your toes and stay for a while. So here, with your convenience, if you want, bend your body still more, keep your hands on the floor and widen your legs properly. Then after that, try to put your head on the floor and stay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, 7. Then very slowly come back, turn your toes inside and slowly rest your body relaxation, okay? Then take a long, slow inhalation. This is especially for leg stretching and hamstring stretches as well as pelvic stretch and girdle stretch also. One long inhalation and exhalation. Because of this standing forward bend, we have one back bending exercise, very simple exercise. First, lift your both the arms up and stretch your arms up, slightly bend the body back along with your head turned back and stay for a while at the Chandrasana or at the Chakrasana. For a while, stay here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then very slowly come back. For this same forward, back bend, another way, try to interlock your hands. And after that, put them on the forehead, then completely press your head back and stay. 1, 2, 3, and relaxations, enough, come back. Again, keep your arms properly open, then very slowly rest and relaxation. Keep your body straight. One long inhalation, exhalation. All right, now coming to our next exercise on the knees. If you have any severe knee issues, avoid the practice or choose good cushion under your knees. So try to bend your right knee on the floor and left knee on the floor, like short leg stance. Few seconds, stay here. Then after that, try to sit properly on the calf and keep you one arm distance between your knees, two fingers, and now raise. Now come to your cat stance or Marjari Asana pre-position. So both the hands must be in the good angle. Both the legs must be in good distance. In between your hands and legs also create a good distance. So in this cat posture, last week, before last week also we did this posture. But today we are doing Pada Chalanam or Pada Sancharanam. Keep your body straight. Open your right leg back and adjust your body and back leg. Lift your back leg. Point your toes up for a while relaxation. Completely stretch your leg back. Then from there, inhalation, lift the leg up. And exhalations down. And second count, inhalations, lift your leg up, exhalations down. Third, last count, inhalations, lift your leg up, exhalations down. Okay, take a long, deep inhalation and exhalation. Same exercise with the same leg, opposite side rotation. One inhalation, then slowly come back, down. Second count, inhalation and down, come back. So make it long and wide cycle and relaxation. After your one leg stretching for a while, relax in any convenient posture or Sashank Asana wide leg variation. And slowly come back. So here, again, come to the next opposite side, open your leg back and put it on the ground as a pre-position. Then after that, keep your body straight and now lift your leg up. From there, start one full cycle, two full cycle, make it long and wide, and three full cycle, then slowly come back. With the same leg reverse, one full cycle, then come back, two full cycle, and come back, 3 full cycle, then right, come back, relaxations. Again for a while, complete relaxation. Alright, slowly come back. Release from the strain, relaxation. So in this exercise also throughout the practice, neck also getting strained. For that neck relaxation, you can just keep your neck bent for a while and relaxation. So here also you can apply arms as a supporters on the head. If you have no neck issues, you can do this simple exercise. Completely keep your head down and stay. Then slowly come back and wide your arms and rest your arms, relax from this Vajrasana also. So whatever posture you want to do, do it very confidently and feel the relaxation while in the posture. Okay, so coming to our next pattern, pranayama, breathing exercise. In this total week, we are not changing that Nadi Shodhana or alternative breathing. Today also we are doing the same exercise. Choose any good surface or even chair or the bed. Try to sit properly with any comfortable posture. If you know lotus, you can put it lotus or half lotus or full lotus, any posture. Try to properly sit. Keep your position straight, chest straight. Just pull the shoulders down and touch your left hand on the left thigh. Close your thumb and close your index finger. Now remaining three finger just open down. Then after that, open your right arm and close your first two fingers. Fold your first two fingers. Open your last two fingers of your right hand and thumb. Then turn them towards your face. This is what we call pranayama mudra or nasa mudra. Then try to close your left nostril with your last two fingers of the right hand. And inhalation with your right nostril. Close your right nostril. Open your left nostril. Complete. Breathe out. And breathe in from your left nostril. And opposite side nostril. Breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, opposite side, breathe out, then opposite side, breathe in, and first nostril, breathe out. Then according to your time, you can choose 5 minutes or 10 minutes or even 15 minutes also. After your pranayama practices and for a while ekagrata abhyas or concentration practice, and close your eyes and observe your breath. Alright, now slowly come back, leave the practices. So choose any one or two practices of this today's schedule or previous schedules to do your self practices just after this session or in the evenings. But here doing is more important. So we are coming to the conclusion. Tomorrow also we have class at the same time. And thank you for giving me this opportunity, and thank you for all. Stay away from all bad habits, stay away from our fear also. Thank you very much.